Greetings. Did hell simply pop into being outside of Allah's awareness?
No, Allah created all things.
Oh, so if you take the Islamic dictum seriously, we have to believe and accept Allah created hell.
Yes, Allah created all things.
So who did Allah make hell for? I mean, has Allah ever sent a prophet, a messenger, to expressly tell us who hell was prepared for? Well, I suppose if you think Mohammed was a prophet of the same God as the prophets of Yahweh, you would assume that Mohammed knew and revealed the same details as the previous prophets. You'd be wrong in that assumption. If you examine the Torah and Bible, you will find one. Okay, I could only find one. Matthew 25:41. Then he will say to those on his left, "Depart from me, you who are cursed, into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels." The context here is that this is Judgment Day. This is God, or Jesus, who we know to be God, speaking. Matthew 25:31, "When the Son of Man comes in his glory and all the angels with him, he will sit on his glorious throne. All the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate the people one from another as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will put the sheep on his right and the goats on his left." So the context is that it is Jesus, or God, judging mankind. But this is the only mention I could find of the purpose of the preparation of hell. And as a topic of discussion and debate, I'd generally say that makes it insignificant. The real issue, however, is the gross difference between the teaching by Jesus and the teaching by Muhammad. You see, the Bible does not focus on this as a huge topic. As I said, mentioning the purpose for preparing hell only once, and clearly stating hell was prepared for Satan, or the devil, and his angels, or demons. Not so the Quran by Muhammad. Surah 224, Shakir translation. "But if you do it not, and never shall you do it, then be on your guard against the fire, of which men and stones are the fuel. It is prepared for the unbelievers." Surah 3131, Shakir. "And guard yourselves against the fire which has been prepared for the unbelievers." Surah 25:11, Shakir. "But they reject the hour, and we have prepared a burning fire for him who rejects the hour." Now, does rejecting the hour not seem like a stupid waste of Allah's attention? Either Allah can make time happen, or he's threatened by someone simply ignoring him. What happens if Allah invites you to Judgment Day and you reject his invitation? Surah 48:13, "And whoever does not believe in Allah and his messengers, then surely we have prepared burning fire for the unbelievers." I know it's just me, but this stupid random voicing is proof of demonic possession. "And whoever does not believe in Allah and his messengers, then surely we have prepared burning fire for the unbelievers." Couldn't Muhammad or Allah stay on their meds long enough to finish a sentence in the same multiple? Try this on for size. Surah 48:13, the Texas translation. "And whoever does not believe in me and my messenger, then surely I, Allah, have prepared burning fire for them, the unbelievers." Is it really too much to ask for the one Allah personality to be strong enough to hold court for a whole sentence? I will gladly die by the scimitar before I submit to the demonic, schizophrenic author of the Quran. But I digress. Surah 76:4, "Surely we have prepared for the unbelievers chains and shackles, and a burning fire. Surah 18:29. And say, the truth is from your Lord, so let him who please believe, and let him who please disbelieve. Surely we have prepared for the iniquitous a fire, the curtains of which shall encompass them about. But this contains a fascinating discontinuity from the rest of the Quran. So let him who pleases believe, and let him who pleases disbelieve. This caught my eye because the general fatalism of the Quran is that you have no choice. Think how many ayats claim Allah has sealed the hearts of the unbelievers. I won't count them now. Perhaps another video. Back to Allah's planned and prepared torturous hatred for those who refuse to believe in him. Surah 33:8, that he may question the truthfulness of their truth, and he has prepared for the unbelievers a painful punishment. 16:62, there is no doubt but that the fire of hell is prepared for them. Now, to be fair, I did find one ayat that said shaitans would also be sent to hell. That's Islamabic for Satan or the devil. But the vast majority specifically talk of fire prepared for the unbeliever. I think you need to cogitate a moment and reflect on something. Almighty God sends dozens of prophets to the Jews over thousands of years. And in all that time, there is very little really taught about hell. Much of the Torah, the Jewish law, dealt with this life and punishment here. Only the Son of God dares speak of the foundation of the preparation of hell. And Jesus describes it as prepared for the devil and his angels. No mention that it was prepared for man at all. Yet the context of Jesus' statement is that men will also be sent there. And this is the not too subtle distinction between Jehovah God and Allah. Over and over, Allah swings the threat of hellfire as a stick of fear. But the worst of it is the declaration that Allah has planned specifically for the eternity of painful torture of those who refuse to submit to him and Muhammad. Allah has gone out of his way to prepare the fires of hell for men he could not intimidate and compel into submission. While the Word of God does not repeat over and over that hell was prepared for Gentiles or sinners or pagans, maybe you are cogent enough to grasp the implications of the difference. Maybe you need it explained to you, Lucy. The God of Abraham does not use a stick of fear to drive you like a sheep to submit to him. This is not the example he set in 4,000 years of dealing with Abraham and his descendants. Nor is it the example he set in 2,000 years since the death, burial, and resurrection of his Son, our Redeemer. Do you really think God wants to fill heaven with people he had to force by threat into submission? Keep it real, G. Spend 10 minutes of honest thought about who God wants to have in paradise or heaven. God's love is free, and his gift of salvation is free to all who turn to him. And God never needed to threaten dozens of times to have prepared hell for unbelievers. But when Muhammad came along, he did, and Allah did. They both needed threats and fear to drive the sheep. There is no relationship between the God of the Torah and Bible and the vengeful Allah of Muhammad's Quran. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.